Hi, welcome to Elonics. In this episode, we'll see how to make a knock switch which turns on when you tap on a piezo speaker and turns off with another tap. We will also see how to modify this circuit into a touch on touch off sensor which works with just a single pair of touch contacts. Explanation of how this circuit works is also included in this video. For the list of components required, link to the circuit diagram or any other information, please refer to the description below. I'll be using this row as positive rail and this as negative rail. Place 555 timer IC on the breadboard such that its notch faces up and the pinouts are as shown. Next, connect pin 8 of the IC to positive rail and pin 1 to negative rail. Then connect pins 2 and 6 and pins 4 and 8 of the 555 timer IC. Now place a 10 mega ohm resistor between pin 2 and negative rail and another 10 mega ohm resistor between pin 6 and positive rail. Next, place an NPN transistor on the breadboard. I've used a BC547 transistor and these are the pinouts with respect to its curved surface. Connect its emitter pin to pin 2 of the 555 timer IC. Now take a piezo speaker, solder a wire to both the film contacts, one at the center and the other at the outer ring. Then cover the entire surface with a non-conductive material. Connect one of its terminals to the emitter pin of transistor and the other terminal to the base of transistor. Next, connect a 100 kilo ohm resistor between the output of 555 timer IC and the collector pin of BC547. Now place a 10 microfarad capacitor between the collector pin of transistor and negative rail. Next, place an LED on the breadboard. Connect its cathode to the output pin of 555 timer IC, which is at pin 3, and connect its anode to positive rail via a series resistor. Find out the value of resistor you need to use from this table. Finally, connect the power supply and the circuit is now ready. The LED turns on with a tap or knock on the piezo speaker and turns off with another tap or knock. One thing you need to note is that you need a slight delay, approximately 2 seconds, between successive knocks on the piezo sensor. A more practical way of using this circuit is by adding a relay. Let's now try to understand how this circuit works. In the previous videos, we independently altered voltages at pins 2 and 6 to make these circuits. But in this project, we'll be connecting pins 2 and 6 to each other so that we can control the output by changing the voltage at just a single point. In a way that if the voltage is more than 2/3 of supply voltage, pin 6 detects that and turns off the output. And if the voltage is less than 1/3 of supply voltage at the same point, pin 2 detects that and turns on the output. We connected two 10 mega ohm resistors to keep the voltage at half the supply voltage so that the output stays stable without fluctuating either ways. Now considering the entire circuit, when we tap on the piezo buzzer, tiny voltage spikes are generated between both its terminals, which causes this transistor to conduct current between emitter and collector pins, and so the output turns on as pin 2 detects voltage less than 1/3 of supply voltage. After this, the 10 microfarad capacitor charges through the 100 kilo ohm resistor and the output pin. So the next time you tap on the piezo sensor, pin 6 detects more than 2/3 of supply voltage and turns off the output. Then the capacitor discharges completely and so we can repeat this process again and again. We can also convert this circuit into a touch on, touch off circuit by using two conductors, one at the base of transistor and the other at the positive rail instead of the piezo sensor. Thanks for watching, do subscribe and have fun.